Chain of custody is very important because it's very important to log the location, the wind direction, possibly the visibility of the area where you took the samples. That's very key. It's very key. Thank you. So, example, this is the chain of custody. Can you please hold it for me?
Okay.
So what happens here is, it's a chain of custody. So, yeah, as you can see, it's the South Durban, it's our organization name. Sample ID, you can call it an alphabet, or you can call it a name, or you can call it a number, it's fine. Sample ID, this was called B. I just took one that's to make an example, but this is a blank one. And then sample location, then I need to be specific exactly where we took that location, because it's very important, because that's its information that forms part of the whole system.
Okay.
And then from there, street address. I need to write the address exactly where we took the location on Baldula. And then probably if it's a corner of Baldula and Sara Road, I have to mention that here. And then from here, date the sample was taken. It was the date will be the 21st today.
Yeah,
21st of the 9th month, 22nd of the 9th month, 2020. I need to write it there. The time is also crucial. It's very important, the time.
Okay.
And then the wind direction. So you have to, it's easy. It's a matter of just looking at the trees and seeing, okay, the wind direction was southeasterly or not, and so forth. But sometimes the wind is very tricky. The wind is steady. You look at the trees, you look at the leaves, and you literally cannot see or differentiate where the wind is blowing. It's fine. You can leave that out. And then you then identify probably what kind of a smell. Was it a rotten egg smell? Was it a benzene smell? Or whatever the case may be. Then you just sit there. And then what did you feel? For example, what did you feel? I was feeling nausea.
Yeah.
I was feeling burning throat, headache. And so forth. Those are symptoms of being exposed to such toxic chemicals as well.
Mm.
And then you would write any other related comments. You're free to write any other related comments.
Okay.
And then on the last page would be part of the chain of custody, and then it's called the chain of custody. Then obviously I will have to, when I arrive at the office, write the company name, the address, write the the person that's in charge of the whole thing. It's Bongani Mthembu, write our details, email, address, client sample ID, exactly the ID, the client's ID, basically where's this area, where's the location, the date and the time. And then this information will go with the teller bag to the lab, and then it also forms part of the, so I'll make a copy, and then it will also form part of the file in the office, so that when the results come, I'll know exactly by identifying, matching the sample ID and the sample ID on the chain of custody in my file, then know exactly which packet was taken when and so forth. Yeah.
Okay, so when you send the teller bag to the lab, do you have to be like specific what you want to find in the, like what chemicals do you want to find in the air when you send the bag to them?
Yeah, that's very important. Definitely. The lab will ask what kind of pollutants would I like to analyze for the sample to be analyzed for. It's either I would say volatile organic compounds, VOCs only, or I would be specific to say probably they must analyze for H2S, sulfur, hydrogen sulfate or sulfur, whatever the case may be.
Okay.
Or option three, I would say do a screen testing. A screen testing, basically, they do an overall screen testing. Okay. And see exactly what kind of pollutants.
And while they're doing the screen testing, will they show which one was the strongest,
exactly,
highest concentration?
Exactly. Okay. They will show in details, example, that benzene was probably maybe 45 part per million. And then sulfur was maybe 32 part per million. And then, different different volatile organic compound, your xylene, your toluene, and so forth and so forth. They will say in details exactly what pollutants and the level of that particular pollutant. Yeah, because that's what actually guides us to know exactly which chemicals were the strongest on that particular day.